Okay, it is Wednesday, October 11th at 5:45, and I'm here. So, trying to decide what to do today. I think I should continue plowing ahead with chapter four. Just because got almost a week starting tomorrow when I'm going to be, well, through Friday when I'm going to be back in Detroit. And so I probably won't get a lot done during that time. So I think I'm going to continue typing today. And just try to get as many words as I can. I need to go back and edit chapters 2 and 3, but I think I'm going to do that when I'm traveling. I've got plenty of time still. I've got like almost 2 weeks before I need to turn in chapters 2 and 3. And yesterday I discovered that the work I did on Monday became obsolete on Tuesday. So I'm gonna go back to chapter 3 and do a lot of rewriting. So that's annoying. But anyway, this is the one I'm working on, this one chapter 4. And I think this section here, there's a lot I can write here, and it can go pretty fast. That's my little plan. So, okay. So here goes. I found these research papers from a couple of years ago that I'm looking at, and they're about like prompt engineering and things you can do with large language models. So like this one from Google. Whoops. And super interesting, but they're kind of like already out of date. So this one's from like 2022. This is going to be a giant problem where everything I'm doing becomes out of date real quick. I really like these examples though, and I wonder if I can use them in the book. I need to find out about that. I guess if I just specify the source, it's probably okay. Oh, wait. So there's the license info. So, yeah, it's Creative Commons attribution 4.0. So I have to give credit. Can do use in any reasonable manner. And okay, so as long as I give credit, I can use these images. So let's look at them. Read this again. Series of intermediate reasoning steps significantly improves the ability of large language. Maybe just this image right here. This is kind of. Maybe I'll just go with my my example that I was writing. I saw like another article somewhere that uses the same image. I don't want to just reproduce the same image that everyone is reproducing. So what I'm going to do is go with my example. And so the idea here is just to sort of explain how to solve the problem and then ask it a new thing and then have it explain how to solve the problem. Okay, so my example is good, but it's not complete yet. What I need to say is like, okay, so a better example would be to say, wait, is my map totally wrong here? That's hilarious. Incorrectly. That would have been a very embarrassing error. Okay, so then I give another example and say, I see. The link. I'm not sure if this needs to be in quotes or italics or whatever, but I'll let my editor deal with that. Anyone who might be watching, I'm just trying to deal with some emails here real quick. I shouldn't do this. I shouldn't check my email, but I've got this whole thing related to a class that I'm supposed to teach where I'm trying to reschedule it. There. I believe there. I think that'll work. Now I think I can work on something here. I should avoid checking my email when I'm trying to write. Maybe I'm think what I need to do is take a break. My head is scattered all kinds of directions right now, and so I'm not able to really concentrate. I probably just need to take a break, breathe. Drink another cup of coffee. And so that's what I'm going to do. Yep. I'll just leave my thing on here. How about until 6:45? I'm back. Forgot my phone. Probably better if I don't have my phone. I think everything is going to be fine. Also think that a lot of these techniques are related to each other. And so I want to skip over some of them. I'm going to leave them in here in case later on, I figure out that it it needs more text, but this one I think I can skip. This one if I can think of a good example, I think this one is useful. A good example. Not so sure that I would even need that one. Let's take a look at some. I'm going to say no on that one too. Okay, so a lot of these here are just not necessary for my purposes.
I don't know.
Maybe I should, just go back and read chapter 3 because I'm having a hard time with this now.
Okay, I think this section is good with just the so zero shot, few shot, chain of thought. And then trying to adapt research papers to a dummy's book, I think, is not the way to go. I need this like simpler tips that are going to be easy and useful. And so, actually, I have an idea. I've got this course that I'm teaching in a couple of weeks about this topic. And it looks like I just got the materials for that course. Yes. No. There are a lot of articles about prompt engineering. And so, like, my task now is to read them all and organize something that is it's going to be useful for coding, because I'm not seeing like a lot of content out there on prompt engineering for coding. And so I think I've probably only written like 50 words today. This is okay. I like these sections. Down here, none of that is really necessary. So in here, this is good. And I think another like general, like sort of a general tip section would be good. So I see many of the, but then I'm only going to talk about three of them. Looks like I've got a problem to deal with. Okay, I've got to quit writing now and go deal with it. Situation. So, maybe back later. Hopefully.